kick-starting her hectic UN agenda, the Prime Minister told a special session that whilst there is emphasis on health, employment and the provision of several social safety nets for the poor, education for Trinidad and Tobago remains the driving force to sustainable development.
Education has received a lion's share of the national budget as we seek to make our education system MDG Plus, which will result in Trinidad and Tobago achieving universal early childhood education by 2015.
A part of this, she said, is the redesign of state programs that will benefit young people at the very beginning of their lives through multi-sectoral education and skills development.
Most recently, in addressing issues of the poor, my government introduced a new program to provide financial assistance for any child born to underprivileged parents.
She said although Trinidad and Tobago has made significant progress in implementing the program of action of the ICPD, her government is cognizant of inherent challenges but remain committed to ensuring equality and equity to harness the talents of current and future generations.
Notwithstanding the strides we have made through proactive intervention by government, including efforts to improve the efficacy of our CSO, Central Statistical Office, in order to promote evidence-based policy making, we recognize that there is still need for assistance from our development partners to strengthen our institutional capacity in some areas, including data collection and statistical systems.
The Prime Minister told the United Nations that her government has begun to put in place measures for a transformative post-2015 development agenda.
In this regard, programs are being developed by relevant national agencies to address issues relating to prenatal and neonatal care, as well as other issues affecting the health of mothers and infants.
She's advocating that sustainable development requires a holistic approach and recognition of the interlinkages between human rights and population dynamics.
I say increasingly diverse household structures and living arrangements requires to plan and build sustainable cities and strengthen urban-rural linkages. It is therefore crucial that we understand the population dynamics at the micro and macro levels for seamless integration into development planning at the national, regional, and international levels.
These, she said, require systematic inputs from all stakeholders in crafting responses to forge global leadership within the family of the United Nations. From New York, this is Gideon Hanoomansingh reporting.